Should I be worried about red crown rot? It's the talk of the town, and I have some questions. Welcome to Soybean Seed Care, Myth or Fact. I'm Bill Biggfoote. As your certified myth expert, I'm here today to investigate more folklore from the field. This year, I've heard a lot of people mention red crown rot, a newer soybean yield threat. So what is it? Is it really something growers should be worried about? I've got Dale Ireland, our agronomic expert, here to help us investigate.
It can be very serious. It's far more devastating than sudden death syndrome. It's moved by soil movement. So anything that moves soil could move the causal organism, which is called Calamectria illicicola, around, that causes red crown rot. Soybeans are definitely a strong host for this. And if you have areas that have symptomology of sudden death syndrome, you know, some of those foliar symptoms that we all know so well, but you have certain fields that seem to show it a lot more often and maybe even every year, that might be red crown rot. There are some similarities as far as the way they look in the field, as far as the foliar yellow speckling and the plant drying up and dying. Now, there are some seed treatments like Saltro that offer protection against red crown rot. Now, it doesn't eliminate it, but it does help bolt on additional yield because you're preserving and protecting more yield than you would if you didn't use Saltro. Red crown rot is something you should know about. Don't stick your head in the ground and just ignore it.
So, should you be on the lookout for red crown rot? That's looking like a confirmed fact. Talk to your local agronomists, retailers, or crop advisors to see if red crown rot is an issue in your area, and if you should invest in Saltro for protection. I'm Bill Biggfoote, certified myth expert, and this has been Soybean Seed Care, Myth or Fact?